Happy New Year, guys, and welcome back to another video on this channel. And as you can see in here in the background, this type of ambient music is something I did over the holidays or the recent days, the recent weeks. And I also moved my whole Muke stand back over to my Eurorack stand or closer together so I can cross-modulate. And also I created a new channel, which is called Polarity on the Music. And I upload some casual dump, or it's basically a dump for all my videos I do on a daily basis, where I just, you know, make these generative patches or some random bits of music. So I upload stuff there to not screw up the algorithm on this channel too much. And I uploaded some kind of generative video recently, and someone said you need to add more glitch sounds. And today I started to do something like this in Bitwig Studio, and I thought it's maybe a nice idea to create this as a kind of tutorial to also show you the modulation possibilities inside Bitwig Studio and, you know, have a new kind of tutorial on this channel. So we have the pulley rack running in the background playing our small little patch. And there are a lot of ways to create glitch sounds, but in this tutorial I want to focus on the sampler. You can also use just some noise and then some filtering modulations. But this time I go for random samples. So we have now here created a new sampler, and you can click this one here, create a new multi-sample, right? That's what we need. And it opens up here this sample patch editor, and we have to drop in here some samples, as it says here, drop samples here. Then I go here most of the times for the Sononym thing, which is basically a sample manager, and it analyzes your hard drive for samples and classifies all these samples. So what you can do now is get out of these random samples I collected over the years. Again, get out some snips and snaps. This is a category here down on the categories tab. And as it turns out, we have selected here a lot of snips and snaps, whatever it means. And select multiple samples, just click the first one and then you hold shift and maybe click here. Then you have all these samples in between selected. And then you drag them over to the sample editor in Bitwig Studio. And now we have all these samples here as multiple layers here in Bitwig, mapped across the whole keyboard. Some of these samples here are only on C3 because they have probably meta text in there which says the sample is only C3. So we can stretch them out and we are good to go. The next step is select all these samples here or all these layers by holding Control and A. And then we can remove the key track. Don't need that. Key track is basically that the sample transposes every time you hit a different key on the keyboard. We don't need that. We just want to have the playback basically as it is, or as the sample is in this original pitch. And the next step would be to go over here to the select panel. And the select panel is basically what you select here with this knob or with this rotary control, right? Every state or every step here should select a different sample from this, because now when we play back here the samples, when I put in here maybe just one note, C3, we play all the samples at once we just loaded in. So pretty loud, and that's not what we want. So back here to the editor, and in this tab, we can now, or we have to select all these layers, which is currently the case. And we can right click here and say distribute select equally. And then you can see here, it moves basically one sample layer to each state of this rotary control. So every time we turn this here, we select a different layer, different sample. It's exactly what we want. The next step would be to use an arpeggiator here and maybe switch it to the free mode here. I don't know how it's called. Yeah, basically, we don't want to synchronize it to the beat grid, or maybe we can. We can go to 64. Maybe this is totally okay. And then we play back basically just one sample. And maybe you can modulate also your rate. Randomly, of course. Maybe go to two steps down. Maybe make it smooth. Something like this. I think this is okay for now. And then we need a random modulator here to select a different sample with this one, right? And maybe we switch this here to note. So every time this gets a new note, which is triggered here by this arpeggiator, we get a different sample. So maybe we switch this also here to hold rate. So this should be working nicely. We get this. And then of course we need a very short attack or decay time here. And maybe also we randomize this. So we randomize basically the decay setting here. And maybe also the pitch differently. Minus 12 and then pitch it up here, 24, 2 octaves. Something like this. You can also maybe modulate here the loudness of the patch. Maybe find a sweet spot here between too quiet and too loud. Okay, nice. So next up would be probably the filter. We do it the same thing. And also resonance. And when you turn up here the resonance a bit more, you can hear at some point you get some nice tonal bits, right? Almost sounds like shattering glass at some point. So I think this is okay for now. Maybe go to bandpass. And maybe peak limiter to get this a bit louder. EQ, cut off the low end. And what I use for reverb here is the adaptive reverb by Synaptic, which gets you this nice long reverb sounds. Maybe delay. Okay, what we also can do is maybe to create some repeater effect here at the end with an FX grid. Just a quick one. We have here audio coming in, audio going out, and we use a recorder in between. Maybe just disable here the dry signal. And we want to sample something. The start of the sequence. of one bar. So every bar we sample here, basically just the first bit. So this goes into recording jack here. You can see every time we hit here the first bar segment, we sample something. And then we duplicate this and we want to play back at the rest of the bar, maybe at these points here. And when you switch to G here, to gate, basically these two triggers form basically one gate. This is one playback section. So when we go here to an oscilloscope, you can see it pretty clearly. So this is basically one high signal here. And when we switch this to T, then we get for each individual bar or segment, we get a trigger. And G is basically one combined signal. Okay, so we want to playback here stuff. And we want to make it a bit more glitchy, so we need a repeater, gate repeat. So it takes basically a gate signal and yeah, repeats it pretty fast up to audio rate. And of course, we modulate this. We'll take a random mod here. We need to find the sweet spot here again. So now this is completely free, and maybe we synchronize this here also to our beat with a trigger or triggers and the clock quantizer. We'll go into the clock quantizer here, go up to 64 nodes and synchronize basically this random stuff to these 64 grid triggers. We have more like a rhythmic feel in these repeats, right? We can mix an original signal here. And the next step would be maybe to disable the glitch sound, because we don't want to have this glitch or this repeating glitch sound here all the time. So maybe we switch this off here at random. So it's off by default. And then we take this trigger here and use a chance of maybe 30%. Every time we get here a trigger from this chance back, we select basically the output. As you can hear, so we have now sometimes a glitch sound and sometimes not. So a pretty simple setup. We can also maybe remove this here. Let's see how this sounds. Yeah, maybe it's even better this way. Maybe it's put it in front of the reverb. We can also use here, maybe in front of the FX grid we just created, we can use a halftime plugin, which basically slows everything down to half the speed. So it with the mix here at 50%, we basically combined the original signal with the slowed down version, which makes it even more complex. We get, you know, a nice rhythmic, glitchy noise texture. And this should be perfectly on the grid. Yeah, nice. I can play around here a bit with the timings. Too much. And I think it fits pretty nicely here. Maybe a bit too loud, but for the sake of the tutorial, you can hear what's going on. But maybe a bit quieter in the background. Yeah, nice. All it needs is maybe a bass sound. I think that's it. Okay, maybe it's still too loud. That's it. Thanks for watching, guys. If you have some questions, please leave it in the comments. Subscribe to the channel. Also watch my other channels, my new channels, and also there's a German channel, Hallo Leute. Everything is linked down in the description. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I see you in the next one.